This is Pam from Follow Your Brush on Facebook. That's my Facebook group, is Follow Your Brush, if you care to join me over there. Or you can just follow me here if you care to. You can like and subscribe. And I am not an instructor. I am a fellow student on a journey. I'm learning. And in so doing, I'm discovering what I like and what I don't like. This week, I have been extremely troubled by and irritated with my own abilities and skills in trying to paint this yellow tree. Well, let me show you what I'm talking about. I saw a picture of a beautiful yellow tree. And I thought, I've got to paint that. It's fall after all, you know, and people are putting up trees and stuff, and it's just pretty. This is my first attempt. And there's the tree, and here's the side trees, and this side I just messed up. This is on my Kilimanjaro paper and that I was playing with. So, but I didn't leave enough light, and I was just not happy with it, and not happy with the way this came. So I thought, oh, let me go again. What is it about this tree that I want to express? I have heard it said or read a quote that said, everybody knows what a tree looks like. What makes yours different? Well, mine's not coming out very different than anybody else's. In fact, I looked at this and I told my daughter, all I need is a little lollipop flowers and a rainbow, and it looks like I'm back in kindergarten. So I thought, what do I need to do to make this different? For one thing, I needed to move this off center, smack dab in the middle, move it off center. And what do I need to tell the story of this tree? Why did it strike me? Why was it so gorgeous? Part of it was the light that was shining through and the different layers of color. I tried again. I like this one better. This one I went in with some lines first with the permanent black ink, and just to kind of give me some structure where I wanted to go. And then I came in and just threw some wet pigment on here and let it dry, and then came back with a little bit more. And actually, I like this better, but I'm still not satisfied. So I'm still on my journey. So I'm back in here today in my studio. And what I have done here, and we're just going to see how this goes, obviously. But I spritzed a little bit of water, and now I'm splattering some of my paint. This is green gold that I'm splattering at the moment. It's a big tree. Had a wide reach, but also had light coming through. So I'm starting with my green gold. I enjoy splatters. If I were to tilt my camera up and you see my wall, you would see how much I enjoy splatter. In fact, let me show you. Can you see that? Look at my wall. That's ridiculous, isn't it? Seriously, I enjoy splatter. But I'm doing this on purpose because that's my story and I'm sticking to it. No. I like to do it this way. I'm wanting to get some of the brilliance that came through the paper. Learning to leave more white. And in watercolor, we do start with the light colors and then we move to the darker colors. One of the other colors that I want to put in here, trying to contain myself, and that's Nicolazo Yellow. This side had more brilliance, as it were. There was more yellow on this side than green. And like I say, the tree came out. It had a wide berth. So I want to kind of get that impression as well. I know there are other ways to splatter. You can do it with a toothbrush. You can, there are all manner of ways. That's just what I'm trying to do at the moment. Today I am working on my Arches paper, 140-pound cold press Arches. This is a big block, so it's not gonna be buckling or anything, hopefully. And now I'm gonna come in very gingerly and tenderly with some of my Quin Gold and let it run. Because in this particular tree, on the edges, as it came down, it has this beautiful darker shades. And I want to get that in here while still leaving the brilliant white and yellow. So I'm feeling pretty good about this one. When I first began painting, years ago when I was a teenager, I wasn't actually really painting, I was sketching. I worked really, really hard on a charcoal picture that just struck me, and it was a hand reaching out of ice in the cold. I'm telling you, I worked really hard on that painting, on that sketch. And then I was like 19, 20. I thought, I'm gonna sign up for an art class at a local high school. We're talking years ago, so these are days before the internet was even, somebody maybe have been inventing, Steve Jobs may have been in his garage, I don't know. But it wasn't around yet. But in order to take classes somewhere, you had to actually sign up and go take classes. So I signed up for this class at a local high school. I'm going to put another tree over here. I'm going to spritz some water and then come in. This is a way that I enjoy painting, by the way. It's just kind of a spritz and go. But I was so excited to take this class. So I took my hand that was reaching up out of the ice like this, that I had so carefully sketched, and took it with me to show the instructor, because I personally was really, really proud of it. And his words to me were, "That's nice. Now we'll do it over and we'll do it right." Well, you know what that did to me as a beginner? I was like, I had no acknowledgement of what I had just worked so hard on doing. And the fact of even thinking about trying to do it again just was devastating. So guess what? I never went back. That was my mistake, actually. I have since learned, took me how many years? I'm getting up in years now. But now I'm learning one of the best lessons I've learned. I'll put some of this down in here too. Is that if you don't like the first one, just go again. I followed Angela Fair for years, about 3.5 years. One of my favorite people of all time. And one of the things I learned from her that is a great lesson, great life lesson actually, is that your first time just shows you what you don't already know. And I love that. I'm kind of being particular about where I'm putting this gold. I know I'm talking a lot too. But the gold, as I was looking at some trees outside my window this morning, actually. It's like that goes in bands. You have, as the leaves are changing, you have dark colors, and then you have a band of light colors. So I'm kind of trying two different things on this. I've got my, this one is a little more defined. This one is just a splatter. I come in here and just soften some of this. I know my last thing we talked about, soft edges and hard edges. Maybe put a trunk in here. So I'm going to soften some of this. I find I enjoy my watercolor if I really let it just kind of be watercolor and do what it wants to do and not think too hard. So this splatter method is not what I always do, but I'm enjoying it yesterday and today. So that's what we're going to do for the moment. And, ooh, I like that tree. I'm not working from a reference photo, and no, this does not look like my reference photo. But isn't that a pretty tree? Oh my goodness, I like that. I'm going to come and add some of this green over here to my other one because I do like that. Let's do a little spritzy spritz. This is already wet, so it's going to give me a little different effect, as we talked about in our lesson, or not really a lesson. I'm not a teacher. I'm an explorer. The video that I did the other day, we talked about hard, I talked about hard and soft edges. And so this kind of lends itself to that because this side is already still damp. So you see how that's going to come across differently. And as it dries, it's going to be lighter. Kind of come in here, do some of this down in here. Just kind of soften some of this. Not a lot, because I do like what it's doing. But you know, there's got to be like a shadow down here. Put a little bit darker edge here. And if it's fall, there's leaves on the ground. Oh, I love this one. Seriously, I love this one. I might. Oof. Now, you kind of have to sit back and look at your painting and think, what is it now that causes me, the creator of this particular painting, to really like this one and not this one? Well, I like that one, but not as well. And look how far we have departed from my first one. See, I wasn't happy with that, but this I love. This to me is what watercolor does. This is what watercolor does. This is what my brain does. That's what my brain does. This is what my brain does. It thinks tree, branches, boop, boop, boop. Watercolor says, please let me do what I want. And isn't that gorgeous? In fact, I'm going to let this dry. And we may just end right here because we got just a little bit of fall leaves at the bottom. I'm gonna let it dry and then I might come back later, but you know what? I really love that. I really, really love that. I love what that's doing and what it's giving me, and it's telling me to please leave it alone and go away. So that's what I'm gonna do. I hope you enjoyed this video as I explore my brain and watercolor. They just don't always get along. So we have gone from thinking to overthinking to beginning to get it, and then I love it. My name is Pam. I have a group on Facebook called Follow Your Brush. If you are so inclined artistically in any form or fashion, please feel free to join. Like and subscribe. I'm not selling anything. I'm not promoting anything or anybody. Just reaching out to those of you that are learning along with me. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again. Thanks. Happy fall, y'all.